Hi guys, so I recently moved my chia plots over to HPool, and in this video I'm going to go over how I did it, because it's not exactly intuitive and there is a little bit of Chinese text to navigate through. I know that some people aren't keen on HPool, there are concerns over centralization, and also the fact that you have to use their mining software and use your 24-word key phrase to generate a signature. And I fully understand that. If you don't trust HPool or you don't feel comfortable using their software, then it's probably best to wait for the release of official pools, which is still scheduled for around the end of the month as far as I'm aware. So I'm not endorsing HPool at all, I'm just going to show you how I went about signing up and farming using their pool, and also show you how much chia I earned over the first couple of days. I took some precautions before signing up and running their software. I created a new email address just for HPool. I used the PC with a fresh install of Windows and no personal information, and I created a new separate Chia wallet for withdrawals. Although I'm using Windows for this video, the process is basically identical for the Mac, the only difference being that you'll have to download the Mac version of their software instead of the PC version. First, you need to sign up for an account on the HPool website. Go to hpool.com and you'll find that everything is in Chinese. You can use your web browser's built-in translation, or if you click up here on the top right, there's a drop-down menu where you can select English. There's an announcement on their site that anyone with less than 2 terabytes of plotted space won't be able to receive payment since their share would be too small to be calculated due to the growth in the network. So if you only have a couple of terabytes plotted, don't sign up with HPool until you have more. To create your account, click on Sign Up at the top of the page. Then you'll have to provide an email address and choose a password. After that, you need to complete a captcha, and then you'll see a message asking you to check your email to complete the sign up. You should find a new email from HPool in your inbox. If you can't see it there, check your spam folder as it may have gone in there. The email is all in Chinese, but there's only one clickable link in there, so just click on that, which should take you back to the HPool website, and the registration will be complete. Now you should be able to log in using the email address and password you supplied at sign up, and you'll have to complete another captcha. And that's it, the HPool account is created. Next, you need to download the HPool software. HPool doesn't use the regular Chia blockchain software. Instead, they provide their own, which you have to install on your computer. On the HPool website, click Download Center at the top, which will bring you to the download page. First, you need the Chia Miner software. Clicking the link will bring you to the GitHub page, where you can download the latest version. Scroll down to Assets at the bottom, and you'll see versions for Windows, macOS, and Linux. Click on the relevant link to download it. You'll also need the Chia Plotter software. Click on the download link to bring you to the GitHub page, then click on Assets and choose the version you want. Again, there are versions for macOS, Linux and Windows. Once downloaded, go to your downloads folder, right click on each of the downloaded files and click on Extract All to decompress them into their own folders. You should end up with 2 folders, one with the plotting software and one with the mining software. Now, to be able to run HPool software without it being blocked by Windows Defender, you're going to have to add a couple of exceptions to the security settings. Click on the Windows logo in the bottom left and then open Settings. Click on Update and Security, then on the left click Windows Security, then click on Virus and Threat Protection. On the next page click Manage Settings under Virus and Threat Protection Settings, then scroll down to near the bottom of the page and click on Add or Remove Exclusions. Click on the Add an Exclusion button, select Folder in the pop-up menu, browse to the folder containing the Chia Plotter and click Select Folder. Then click again on Add an Exclusion, click Folder, browse to the folder containing the Chia Miner and click Select Folder. Now you should be able to run the HPool software without it being blocked by Windows. Next, you need to add the Chia Pool on your HPool account. Make sure that you logged into the HPool website. Click on your email address and select Personal Center in the menu. Click on Open Pool under Pool on the left. You'll see a message saying not open, please open first, because we don't have any pools open yet. click on All, then scroll down to Chia Eco and click on Open Pool. You should then see a message saying that the mining pool was successfully opened. And under your pools, you should see Chia Eco listed. Now you need to generate and add your signature data. This is the part that many people have a problem with, as it requires using your 24-word key phrase. Open a command prompt window and drag the Chia plotter executable into it. Press enter and it should say input mnemonic word. Now you need to go into the official Chia app, click on keys, then click on the eye to view your private key and your seed phrase. Now you need to highlight all of the words under seed, press Ctrl and C to copy them, then switch back to the command prompt and press Ctrl and V to paste them. Press enter and you should see a lot of text. The one you need is the long sequence right after where it says signature. Highlight the text after signature and press Ctrl and C to copy it to the clipboard. Now go to the HPool website, click on Open Pool under Pool on the left, then click Go to Configuration. You'll see a box asking for bind signature data. Click into the box and press Ctrl and V to paste the text you just copied. Then click on the button labeled Bind. If you ever want to leave HPool in the future and go back to solo farming, you'll have to click Unbundling Computer Power at the bottom. Now you need to remove all of the plots you're currently farming from the official Chia app before adding them to the HPool farming app. If you don't do this, you'll end up getting banned for double farming the plots, which is something I've heard of happening to several people. In the Chia app, click Plots on the left, then click the three dots next to add a plot, and in the menu, select Add Plot Directory. Then click the trash can icon next to each of your folders to remove them from your farm. And when you're done, click on Close. Now we need to configure the HPool mining software. Open the folder with the mining software in it, look for a file called config.yaml, and open it up in Notepad. By default, the mining software has all Chinese text. So unless you understand Chinese, you need to add a new line in this file to change it to English. Just add a new line anywhere in the file and type language colon space en. Then you can save the file and quit Notepad. Now double click the HPool Miner Chia GUI executable to run it. If you see a message from Windows saying that it was blocked, click More Info and then click Run Anyway. When the software runs, you'll see at the top here it says please configure API key. To configure the API key, click on the button labeled Settings here at the top. Then switch over to the HPool website and you'll find the API key here under Configurations. Click on the clipboard icon to copy it to the clipboard, then switch back to the miner software, paste it into the box for API key, and then click the button at the bottom with the Chinese characters on it. Now you just need to add your Chia plots to the HPool mining software to start farming. Click the button labeled Add, then browse to the drive or folder containing your plots and click Select Folder. That will add the folder to your farm. To add more drives or folders, just click on Add again and the software will add any plots in the folder you select. If you look on the HPool website now under Open Pool, you should see your total online power value increasing as you add more plots. You can also check that your plots are working by looking under Online Plots. You should see the word signed in green next to each of them. So now let's take a look at how much I've earned over the first couple of days of using HPool. In total, over 2 days and 7 hours, I made 0.0142 Chia, or about 0.0059 Chia per day. This is with only 6.5 terabytes of online space, spread across one 6 terabyte drive and a portable 1 terabyte drive. There's a site, hpoolchiacalculator.com, which I'll link down in the video description, where you can calculate how much you'd earn through HPool, depending on the amount of storage you have. Finally, I'm going to talk about withdrawals. Before you can withdraw from HPool, you need to verify your phone number by SMS. To do this, click on Go to Bind next to Phone under Personal Center, then choose your country code, enter your phone number, and click Send. Then you'll have to complete a captcha, click SMS, and a 6-digit code will be texted to your phone. You have to enter the numbers in the box and then click Authentication. Then you'll get another code by email this time, which you can just copy from the email and paste it into the box. Then click modify and you're done. I've heard of people having problems with this step, but for me it was pretty straightforward. So overall, after the first couple of days, personally I've been very satisfied with HPool. My one issue is that I haven't been able to add plots on network drives. I've only been able to add plots stored on drives connected directly to the computer running the mining software. And I don't know why that is. I understand people's concerns about HPool, but for me at least it seems to be working well so far. Although obviously it's only been a couple of days, so it's still very early. I hope this video helps if you've been thinking about signing up to HPool. If you have any questions, put them down in the comments below and I'll do my best to answer them. That's it for this video, thanks for watching.